Good morning, class. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe. So, your class, today we are going to start our new chapter, chapter number 2, Memory and Storage. And today we are going to start a new topics. First is introduction, second internal memory, third is external memory. So, student, let's start this topic. Class 4th, your chapter number 2, Memory and Storage, and today we are going to discuss about internal memory and external memory. So let's start this topic. First of all, content, you can see introduction, RAM, ROM, PROM, EPROM, auxiliary storage devices, magnetic tab, hard disk, floppy disk, optical disk, CDR drive, CDR, double disk, DVD, Blu-ray disk. So all are a content of related of a memory. Now see a structure of a internal of a memory. So RAM, ROM, database, CPU, address bus, motherboard and disk drive. So see a picture properly, student, class 4. Now see a processor of a memory. First of all, memory, then process this function, then input diva, enter the input data and after output data and last storage, store the memory. So this is a chart of a memory. Okay, student, class 4, you can see a memory device in a RAM, ROM, PROM, EPROM. So it's a memory devices. Then second thing is a storage devices, auxiliary storage devices, magnetic tab, hard disk, floppy disk, optical disk, CDR drive, CDR, double disk, DVD, Blu-ray disk. So all are storage devices. Now see next structure of a CPU. So first arithmetic logic unit, second control unit, then input device, output devices, then memory and storage. Now talk about this characteristics of storage devices. First, speed, volatility, access method, portability, cost and capacity. So all are characteristics of storage devices. So let's see a basic units of measurement, bit, binary digit, smallest unit of measurement, two possible values 0 or 1, then byte is a total 8. Okay, so 8 bits equal to 1 bytes. So let's see next RAM, ROM, PROM, EPROM, memory device. So memory is one or more sets of chips that store data, program, instructions, either temporarily or permanently. So it is critical processing components in any computer, and PCs use several different types like RAM, ROM, PROM, EPROM. Memory devices two most important are, first RAM means random access memory, second ROM means read only memory. And so they work in a different ways and perform distinct functions. First CPU register and work in a cached memory. Now see a second thing is a read-only memory ROM. So read-only memory ROM refer to the memory chip containing instruction that tell the computer what to do when it start up, and this information is stored permanently in it. So during the manufacturing process, unlike RAM, ROM is non-volatile. And it means that even after you turn off your computer, the content of ROM will not be lost. So it's a ROM read-only memory. Then come on external memory. So external memory is your store information for a long period. So it is aided because internal storage of computer is inefficient to store a large amount of data. So the external memory is also called a secondary memory. So it consists of storage devices such as hard disk, compact disk, DVD and pen drive. So number first is storage device, the hard disk, you can see here. So it is the main storage device for computer, and it is fixed inside the CPU cabinet and contain all the software and data. So hard disk is made up of multiple disks, so called platters. So data is recorded on both the sides of the disk. Hard disk can store up to 16 TB of data. Now next is a compact disk. Compact disk means CD. So compact disk, CD is an optical storage medium. It is a thin circular disk with a reflective metal coating. So it can store up to 700 MB of data and measures 4.7 inches in diameter. So CDs can hold text, graphics, sound, images and videos. Now next storage is a digital versatile disk DVD. So DVD, digital versatile disk, digital video disk is an optical storage device. So that can be used to store data and record movies with high video and sound quality. So a DVD is similar to a CD in shape and size, but can store huge amount of information. The storage capacity varies from 4.1 GB to 17 GB storage in DVD. Okay. So now see of a picture of magnetic drive storage device. Next is hard disk. Blu-ray disk. So student, all this topic, just read and revise all this topic. Internal memory and external memory. Revise all this memory part. Two parts of internal primary memory is called RAM, ROM. Then second, external secondary memory, CD, DVD, hard disk, flash disk. Okay, now second, external memory, hard disk, compact, digital versatile disk. So all this all examples of external memory. Okay, students. So class 4th, your chapter number 2, revise all this topic.